feeling helpless, thousands of miles away from devastation, wondering what he could do to help his family and friends. Alex Stresa, a PhD student at Hampton from Nepal, decided to put his expertise to good use. He's put together a team that's mapping the effect of the recent earthquake to guide the ongoing relief efforts on the ground. Today he showed me how.
Usually like we Skype with them or we talk on the phone around like 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock on Saturday.
But on April 25th, a call came in at 5 a.m. that Alex Stresa and his wife missed. Soon after, news of a 7.8 magnitude earthquake that rocked their native Nepal, killing thousands of people, destroying thousands of homes.
And we were so scared of that, and we started trying to contact our parents.
It took 2 hours to connect, but their parents in Kathmandu were okay.
But because of the earthquake, like they have to stay outside. They couldn't live in the house because of those ongoing aftershocks. So they have been living outside on a tent.
Thousands of miles away, Alec, a contractor at NASA's Langley Research Center, who specializes in satellite-based remote sensing of the Earth, put together a plan to help.
Zooming into this area, into the pre-event and post-event images, and then looking what are the differences between those two and see like if we could get some information from that that we could provide to our local organizations back in Nepal.
He formed a Facebook page where people of all expertise have come together and found extraordinary things they can do.
There used to be a helipad in the districts, so now those helipads are destroyed because of that, and they are asking like if we could look at the satellite images after event and then find some flat area where they could land their helicopter with the relief things.
They can use these images to look at the condition of the roads and see how landslides have affected them to see which routes relief teams should use. They can even tell which open areas are now filled with tent villages where people with destroyed homes have now migrated to. This isn't work they're getting paid for, it's personal.
The things like we used to play around this area, and now when we go back and see there's nothing, something like that, it feels like very emotional from inside, like we will miss those places.
With this work, there's no quick fix.
Alec has gotten the Department of Atmospheric Sciences at Hampton to do a fundraising campaign. His department at NASA is doing the same, and I'm putting information for three organizations helping with relief efforts that he mentioned that you can donate to in my web story on wavy.com.